this video, we are going to learn to draw the developed winding diagram of a 6-pole 18 armature slots double layer lap wound DC machine, and the drawing of sequence diagram and the fixing of the position and polarity of the brushes, and also one more thing, the direction of rotation of the armature. So that we are going to show in this video. For the solution of this problem, so we have the data for this: number of poles are 6 in this problem, and then number of slots are 18 slots, and then double layer, due to the double layer, the number of conductors will be the double the number of slots, because in each slot we are going to place the two conductors. One conductor will be on the top layer and another conductor will be on the bottom layer. So here the representation of top and bottom conductor will be made in the winding diagram like: the top layer conductor will be represented as a continuous line, and the bottom layer conductor will be represented as a dash line. So here the numbering will be made as per the top layer and the bottom layer. So here the top layer conductor will get all the odd numbers, and the bottom layer conductors will get the even numbers. So later I'll show you in the winding diagram how to represent the numbers and the lines. Okay, here the pole pitch is 6, 6 conductor will cover one pole, and then the calculation of front pitch and the back pitch is given here. So this, by solving these two equations, we'll get the back pitch as 7 and front pitch as 5, and by the satisfaction of the rules, like for a simplex lap winding, YB and YF should be odd, and they should be differ by 2, and that means the difference between that YB and YF should be 2, and by the satisfaction of this condition, we can proceed for the winding table. So like YB as 7 and YF as 5. So now in the winding table, we can see here the winding table consists of the back connection and the front connection. At the back, we have back pitch 7, conductor number 1 is connected to conductor number 8, and at the same in the front, conductor number 8 is connected to conductor number 3. And now we'll move on to the winding diagram. And one more thing, the direction of rotation here. So the direction of rotation for the generator will be in a clockwise direction, and for the motor will be in anti-clockwise direction. In this direction, we have to represent, or we have to show the arrow mark direction in the winding diagram. Now we'll move on to the winding diagram representation. For the winding diagram, showing the conductor, I'll draw the line having 100 mm length, and then to the right side 15 mm, and then I'll draw the second layer conductor having this 100 mm length, and then the second layer conductor should be represented in a dash line. For that, so we have to change the property of this line, and we have to make the dash line for that. So here in this properties toolbar, we have the line type. So in this line type, we have to select the line type and then go for the other, and we need to load the line types. So here click on the line and then select all the lines and then load, and now we have seen all the types of lines here. So this dash line, we are going to use it for our bottom layer conductor. So now select the line and then click on this line type and then click on this dash line. Okay, now we have shown the bottom layer conductor in dash line, and this is the top layer conductor in continuous line. And now we need to select these two, and we have to make the number of conductors as 36 conductors for 18 slots. So we have to place the 36 conductors in 18 slots. For that, we'll go for this rectangular array. So we'll make number of columns as 18, because we have already drawn two conductors, and then we'll go for the number of rows as 1, and the distance between, I'll give the distance between 30, because we have already given the distance between two conductors, and then need to close the array. So now this represent the 36 conductors placed in 18 slots. The top layer and the bottom layer, you can see the top layer conductor is represented in continuous, and the bottom layer is represented in the dotted line, and the naming, the numbering should be given like: the top layer conductor will get odd number like 1, 3, 5, 7, and the bottom layer conductor will get an even number like 2, 4, 6, 8. So like this number we are going to given for the conductor. I'll give the numbering by using the multi-line text. I'll draw the text box, and then text height, I'll give 5 mm text height, and then I'll type the numbers from 1 to 36. After giving the numbering, we need to arrange the numbers for the respective conductors. Like top layer will get the odd numbers and the bottom layer will get the even numbers. After giving the number, so now we need to connect the front connection and the back connection. From the winding table, it is shown that conductor number 1 is connected to conductor number 8. You can see that in the winding table, conductor number 1 is connected to conductor number 8 at the back, and at the front, conductor number 8 and at the front, conductor number 8 is connected to conductor number 3. So that same thing we need to show here. For that, I'll take the line. Conductor number 1 is connected to conductor number 8, and an angle 45 degree, I'll draw the line. And then same thing from the conductor number 8, an angle of 135, draw the line. And then same thing at the front, conductor number 8 is connected to conductor number 3. Okay, after connecting the conductors, front and back connections, the conductor which is connected to the back, that we need to show in the dotted line or the dashed line. For that, I'll change the property of this to the dashed line. And then now after that, we have to connect all the conductors. Like, I'll select these four connections and then I'll go for the array. The number of columns should be 18. And then number of rows 1, and the distance between should be 30, and then close the array. So now we have got all the connections, and then the extra connections that we have to select, and then delete the extra connections and the conductors which are not connected at the starting. So that we need to connect it by copying these four conductors from this point and placing at the end point of those conductor. And now we have connected all the conductors from first conductor to the last conductor. So now after this connection, we need to draw the commutator segment. So for that, I'll take the line from the first conductor. I'll draw 30 mm line, and then for the commutator segment, I'll draw this 15 mm, and then to the downwards 20 mm. And then to the right side again, I'll draw this 30 mm, and then to the top 20, and then to this, complete this section. And now need to select this part and then go for the array. To make the number of commutator segments as 18, I'll give the number of columns as 18, and then rows 1, and the distance between should be 30, and then close the array. And now we got the commutator segments. For this commutator segments, we have to number, and I'll take this number and then place it here. And I'll delete the other remaining numbers. I'll select the text height as 10 and then close the text editor and place the numbers exactly on that particular segment. So now we have given the numbering for the commutator segments. There are 18 segments in this winding, and after this we have to show the poles. There are 6 number of poles, and each pole will cover 6 conductor. Pole pitch is 6. For that, take the rectangle and draw the rectangle covering 6 number of conductors, and then same thing, copy the same and then place it along the windings. The 1, 2, 3, then 4, 5, and the last one, the sixth one. You know, we have placed 6 poles along the winding. So for the poles, I'll name it by single line text. The north, and this is south. Then here the north, and this is south, and this is north, and this is south. So after giving the naming of this pole, and we have to show the direction of current in the conductor. For that, I'll take the polyline, and then I'll draw the arrow mark indicating that the direction, width 5, 0 and 10, and then select the arrow mark, and then make the array number of columns 6, and then rows 1, and the distance between 30, and then the distance between should be 15. And then close the array, and now select this and then copy and then place it all over the conductors. And now we have placed the arrow mark all along the conductors, and for the south pole we have to indicate in downward upward direction. For that, select all the arrow mark comes under the south pole, and then go for the mirror and do the mirror, then erase the source object. So now we have changed the direction of the arrow mark under the south pole here. And then for the position of brush and the polarity of the brush, we have to go for the sequence diagram. From the sequence diagram, and we can easily get the position and polarity of the brush. For the sequence diagram, I'll draw the sequence diagram at the side of this here. For that, I'll take the line and I'll draw 50 mm line, and then to this 15, then to the downwards again 50 mm, and then 15 mm line, and then select, and then we'll make the array number of columns 18, and then number of rows 1, and the distance between should be 30, and then close the array. And after that, the end, we have to draw one more conductor here, 50, the starting conductor. Okay, for this we have to give the naming. And the sequence diagram, we have to number the sequence of conductor 1 is connected to conductor 8, and after numbering we have to show the direction of the current in each conductor that is represented in the winding diagram here. Conductor number 1 to conductor number 6 are in downward direction, and then conductor number 13 to conductor number 18 are in downward direction. Again, the conductor number 25 to 30 are in downward direction. Like this, we have to show the direction for this conductors, and then the remaining conductors are in upward direction. So that we need to show. So after showing the direction, okay, after representing the arrow mark or the direction of this current in each conductor, so we need to get the position of brushes. The position of brushes can be get. The position of the brushes can be known by the thing here. The conductor number 1 and 6 is having the same direction, the adjacent conductors. For that, we'll draw one line. We'll drop this line here, 30 mm line, and then same line we need to copy and then that we need to place it another at the 36 and 31 here. These two conductors are in upward direction, the adjacent conductors having the same direction, and then the next conductor will be at conductor number 30 and 25, and the next conductor will be conductor number 24 and 19 here, and then the next conductor will be 18 and 13, and the next conductors will be 12 and 7. Okay, for this we need to connect the brushes, and then polarity can be obtained by, for the upward direction we are going to show the negative polarity, and for the downward direction we'll show the positive polarity. For that, we'll take the single line text, and then we'll draw the polarity symbol here for this negative and for this positive, and then for this negative, and then for this positive, and then for this negative, and then for this positive. And then same thing, just we need to identify this conductor number 1 and 6 are connected to which segment, and there we need to place the brush. So here conductor number 1 and 6 are connected to the segment 1, there we need to place the brush. For that, take the rectangle and draw the brush covering complete segment, and then copy the same and then place it at the next segment where the conductor number 12 and 7 are connected. The conductor number 12 and 7 are connected to this fourth segment, and then the next brush will be at the conductor number 18 and 13, so that is connected to this segment number 7, and then the next brush will be at the conductor number 24 and 19, so the conductor number 24 and 19 are connected to this 10th segment, and then the next brush will be at conductor number 30 and 25. Conductor number 30 and 25 are connected to this segment number 13, and then the next brush will be at the conductor number 36 and 31, so that conductor number 36 and 31 are connected to this 16th segment, and there we are going to place the another brush. So after placing the brush, we need to connect all the positive brushes and all the negative brushes. So here this is the positive brush, and that we need to connect to this brush, and then this is another positive brush that we need to connect it, and after that we need to connect all the negative brushes. So after that we need to show the polarity of the supply here. So for that, take the single line text and then indicate the polarity here. So here this will be the positive and this will be the negative polarity, and here somewhere we need to show the jumpers. And after that we need to hatch the poles and the brushes. For that, take the ANSI 31 and hatch all the north pole, and the brushes comes under the north pole, and then go for the hatch again and hatch all the south pole, and then brushes comes under the south pole, and just change the angle in close. And now this is the winding diagram of a simplex double layer progressive lap winding. So here the double layer, the changes in each slot, we are going to place the two conductors. One will be the top conductor and another will be the bottom conductor. The top conductor is shown in the continuous line, and the bottom conductor is shown in dashed line. And then the numbering also done for the top layer conductor. The numbering will be done for the top layer conductor. All the odd numbers are given, and for the bottom layer conductors, all the even numbers are given to the bottom layer conductors.